what am I doing here? I don't fit here. Well, relax, I'm not losing my nerves here. It's just a odd, what, 1,000, 1,200 of you. That's okay. What I was really recalling was my internal dialogue. An internal dialogue that I've been thinking over and over again in a self, fulfilling prophecy. I'm not good enough. That's what came to be. As in academics, I was pretty average in recalling textbook knowledge on exam papers. And when I said average, I'm sure you understand, it's kind of putting a little mildly. I was a dreamer. I could not comprehend or connect with realities or concepts that I could not sync with. As a result, it dented my confidence and I grew inwards. I became an introvert in the class and an extrovert out of it. That was my first experience of duality. As a young child, I was brimming with energy, and you can imagine how manageable I was at home. So my parents initiated my training in dance, and that's where I began at the age of 5. I started dancing first as a hobby, and then as I grew older, I started dancing for the internal bliss it brought to me. I connected with myself. Many times I disconnected with the outside altogether when I was on stage and entered something like a trance. It's difficult to explain what that kind of an experience was, but I'll attempt to explain what it did. Looking back at the formative years of my education, the only time a person with average intelligence in the conventional terms ever excelled beyond herself was when her creative energies were being channelized. It was difficult for me to see the connection at that point of time. And as most of us do, we kind of put it in a box during exam time. And that actually became a very stressful time for me. In dance, I performed nationally and internationally and started getting appreciation for the work. It encouraged me to do better. I started doing my own choreographies, many of them dealing with, besides the classic, reinterpretation and reimagination of some traditional work. So, and it was also the time, sometimes it overlapped with the academics, and that was when I started seeing the connection. The outstanding effort awards that I got probably in the academics was also during the time when I continued to practice and didn't put it in a box. So when I saw the connection, I, instead of randomly experiencing both, I intentionally started overlapping. And the creation, the duality, seemed to be a little calmer. Since childhood, I was very fascinated by medicine. And as a child, I remember writing down essays about how I want to help people. And now if I see, as kids, I think most of us did that. And kids today, if you see in essays, they would be writing how we want to help others, how do we want to change the world. And then we grow up. My fascination for medicine took me to the field of biotechnology, and specifically to genomics because of its immense potential. So genomics is the study of DNA, which answers the question of our physical and mental attributes. Why do I look the way I look? Why do I think the way I think? Why do I behave the way I behave? What happens when we fall ill? How do we recover? So these are the questions which genomics attempts to answer and leads towards personalized medicine, which was absolutely fascinating for me. So as a mix of scores and the exposure that I got due to my interest as an artist got me through a very coveted course in the university. For me, science, my pursuits in science and as a dancer of classical Indian form existed parallelly. Rather, one fed into the other. My dance fed into my scientific acumen and my dance gained more meaning because of the thematic variations that I was encouraged to undertake being trained as an experimental scientist. Now, science is serious stuff and research requires a lot of patience. I'm intrinsically a very restless person. I think on my feet, quite literally, and you can imagine what it's doing to me right now, standing in one place and talking to you. So, in science, or in research, the results don't happen overnight. It takes time, months, sometimes years, to come to some conclusion. So during this time, if you're a scientist working in a lab, the least number of attempts that you can make to put two segments of DNA together to create a system which amplifies the DNA so that you can study it, makes your social standing in the laboratory markedly high. And when I started seeing the connection, for me, dance existed in one universe, that of being artistic, creative. Science was rational, analytical, existed in another universe. And I started to observe something very interesting as a child, that the very basis of music and dance was based in maths. So it's grounded in tals, which is a system of rhythms which has beats which are to be recited in a particular time frame, and lev, which is the tempo or the speed of this tal. To give you an example, the 16 matra, the 16 matra teen tal, which is very popular, goes like this: ta din din, ta ta din din, ta ta tin tin, ta ta din din, ta. And the variation of it, where the time remains the same, but the number of cycles increase. Ta din din ta, 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 ta. So how do you modulate it? It comes down to even fraction, and that was fascinating. Using fascinating and arithmetic or maths in the same breath, I even amazed myself. How could I do that? As a scientist, because it requires a lot of patience, and I was not very patient, I was a very restless person. The only reason that I stood grounded and did reasonably well in terms of the awards, the publication, and the patents is because of the grounding and the meditative effect of dance. I realized that, and I started overlapping it even more. You've got an attention span of a squirrel, my husband jokes often. Well, I later learned that the 1 second attention span of a squirrel increases markedly to 4 minutes in the presence of an acorn, provided it finds an acorn. I never acknowledged the fact of being a dancer in the scientific community or being a scientist in the dance community, primarily for the fact that I feared not being taken seriously, of having too many distractions or not being focused. But then I realized it's a disservice because of what it was doing for me. Because of the existence of the two and the connection between the two, I existed as a scientist and a dancer. I would have been probably neither in the absence of any one of them. And I had to believe, and I agreed finally with myself, that I was not only a scientist, I was not only an artist. I was both. In different measures, over different times, but I was both. And I'm not alone. there are many, many like me. Now, this is not what you term as multiple personality disorder, as my Google search sometimes very kindly tends to suggest. Here, one facet leads productively into the other. As Malcolm Forbes said, that we overvalue what we are not and undervalue what we are. It's about finding yourself. Many centuries ago, artist extraordinaire Leonardo da Vinci agreed that knowing science and mathematics made him a better artist. This popular work by Vinci of the Vitruvian Man is a very famous amalgamation of art, anatomy, science, and mathematics. It's said that Albert Einstein was once asked by a very curious mother who wanted to, who aspired for a son to become a scientist, and she asked, "What should I train him in so that he becomes a scientist?" And Albert Einstein said, "Read him fairy tales." The woman was confused. She said, "Sir, I think you don't understand. I want him to be a scientist, a great scientist like you." Albert Einstein said, "Well, very good. Read him more fairy tales." What he implied was that creative imagination is essential for a scientist, and fairy tales are the stimulus in that order for a child. Megan Washington stutters when she talks and she dreads public addresses. But when she sings, she loses her stutter. What did she do? She sang. She sang even. that we undertook over a year back. As global citizens, we cannot be totally blind to what's happening around. And where the success is more in terms of numbers, in terms of downloads, likes, tweets, it's very easy to lose focus of what the impact should look like. Our impact, what I was personally passionate about, was healthcare. So we started building on our team where one person impacts more. So that is what a million impacting a billion. The trigger came mainly from this, where many people are left outside in the cold waiting for an overworked doctor to see them for 5 minutes. We started building on solution, whereas the solution comes from within the community, is driven by the community, and is scaled and sustained by them. You also answer your creative calling, and that is what the Googles and the Apples work on. Upload a picture, tell people how you did it, what camera you used, or doodle for Google to be part of the branding, or make an app on the open source Android. That is where you answer your creative calling, and that is what people and corporates know that make people tick. As parents, it is important that we give a safe haven for our children to explore their creativity. My daughter started her formal education this year, and having been trained on art, the principles of art, music, and play, she enjoyed the first couple of months, but then she stopped doing it. And that's when we realized she was being asked to write, and she did not like it because that came in lieu of what she enjoyed doing. In one of the futile attempts where I did sit down with her to teach her how to write, she turned to me and said sternly, "Don't scribble or I'll walk out of the classroom." I understood where the problem was. She likes to scribble, don't we all? We scribble each time we come up with a new idea, a new theme. It's a mental scribble, it's a physical scribble, it's on paper, it's up in the air, but we scribble. And that is what drives creativity. Now she has a dedicated writing time and a scribble time. So what I mean to say is there is no blueprint for being the best version of yourself. There is only a recipe. You have to modify it, add, remove, spice up a few things, sweeten a few things to be able to reach an equilibrium which sticks. Because the best version in you will inspire the best version in others. I'll end with this quote. The creative adult is the child who survived. Find the child in you. Find your best version. Thank you.